Back, my angel. This is episode 11 of season 4, kind of the halfway mark of this season after this episode, which is pretty exciting. Also very exciting is the prospect that Angelus is back and hopefully going to provide some insight on what's going on with the beast, that whole situation, why Angel couldn't remember, what's going on with that. But yeah, we're coming off a really strong episode that I really enjoyed. You know, I'm still thinking about it and making my mind up and everything, you know, very cool twist, like, show that a lot of it was a dream, and to have Angelus back is really nice and everything, but I'm still kind of weighing up in my head, like, how do I feel about it? A lot of you guys made really good points about, you know, it showcases a lot about Angel's character, how far he's come, you know, what he would want from his life, which is a really cool way of looking at it. So that's definitely kind of helped kind of look at the episode and examine it in different ways, which I always enjoy doing, like sitting on what they're trying to do with it and everything. So I like that a lot. But you know, some twists you like, some twists you don't, some twists you're like, oh, we'll see where they go with it. And that's still kind of what it is. As long as the Angelus returning arc is kind of worth it and everything, you know, I don't really mind being duped for so much of the runtime. But you know, just because there's a twist doesn't make it good. That is what I will say in response to some messages I've gotten. And yeah, we'll see where they go with it. But I am very excited at the prospect of Angelus coming back, because I'm always keen for them to explore that a bit more. Cause it just reminds me of late season 2 Buffy, which is kind of when I really, really fell in love with reacting to the Buffyverse. So yeah, I guess we'll see what's going to happen. But I am hyped for Angelus. Hopefully there's going to be quite a lot of focus on that, because if we get kind of a filler episode to focus on someone else, it'd be a bit of a strange decision, but I don't think that's where they're going with it. Very, very hyped. Let's get into the episode. Again with the jumping. I mean, sometimes it does work like that, but other times, my. Looks like a light bulb.
He's dangerous. I know. I've seen it.
Killed Willow's fish.
But we're doing the right thing.
And Jenny.
As long as if you go into the woods tonight, you're in for a big surprise. That's Slayer. She's a pistol.
Hell yeah.
I've mentioned this moment many times. Anything you want to know. How sweet that virgin gypsy tasted. Special smell of a newborn's neck. My first nut. Now that's a great story.
How about your favorite color?
Stop that. Maybe he doesn't remember the good times. Maybe he won't let himself. So like him.
I was gonna say, it does sound like him, to be fair.
Here's one. You want to impress the girl. Move in. Get her to love you. After a couple days of flowers and chocolate-covered cherries.
Oh.
Don't let him get to you, Kiwi. He's not the only one that's getting.
Charles.
I know.
I don't know if Gunn can keep his cool for long, though.
You're not fooling anyone. Get some new clothes, cool haircut, hit the gym. You're still the same loser none of the other kids wanted to sit with at lunch.
Yet you're locked in that cage.
I don't know, he's pretty badass now.
Yeah. We'll bring Angel back and be no worse off than we were.
Making you a failure again.
You want to waste my time, you can rot down here.
Nice stamina.
No one judges Wesley more than Wesley, I think.
Anyone ever call you a champion?
Wesley, you're a champion. Don't listen to him.
I do my part.
Faith. Good job being her watcher. She turned out to be a peach.
And you managed
to... Not anyone's finest moment.
I guess you just can't understand that special bond between dad and son. Giving out your own father's
shame. Fuck. I knew he'd get to the dad eventually.
I love you, but you were so bad.
Chicks.
Which do you think is worse, Wes?
Stealing my kid like you did, or banging him like Cordelia?
All that bumping grinding.
Well, now that's just ridiculous.
Oh, of course, those two don't know, do they? With your own... I forgot Gunn and Fred didn't know.
At least you thought you were doing...
Oh, shit! Ooh, what else can he spill?
Othello and Desdemona. My favorite couple.
I hope it doesn't end the way that did.
I'm lying there, listening. Hands under the covers. I can't help myself. It's so gripping.
Too much information. Oh! Jesus!
Might get some now.
Oh, yeah, nice. Hush, little Angelus, don't say a word.
Angelus is unpredictable. He'll take any opening.
I mean, that was pretty predictable.
This is his.
Well, if you don't like it, I can.
Who did you think it was?
Angelus said some things about the night we... You know? The weirdness is because everyone knows.
You don't want to be with me? Fine, you're not. Don't tell me what to do.
Charles heard what Angela said. The stuff about...
Hey.
Yeah.
How do I feel about you?
There's nothing wrong with it.
Yes, there is.
What are you doing?
Hey, who's watching the monitor? What's going on?
Shenanigans!
Stay away from her.
Probably sound advice at that. I mean, oh my goodness!
Great idea, Wes, stealing Angel's kid. Oh, was losing him a part of your plan too?
Go ahead. Throw some more blame around. It's what you're best at. You
wanna
say
shit.
Now, he's a gun, you can't give her what she needs.
Fuck! What the hell are you doing, you idiots? How dare you? Oh shit, oh no. Fools! Fools! All of you fools! Except Vaughn, you're a sweetheart and I love you. I mean, Fred kind of kissed him back, so that's not ideal. You're just a mess. You're a mess. I'm a mess.
Everyone's afraid of you. Is that my shirt?
No, it's Angel's shirt.
Looks good on you. Son. So did Cardi. She looks good on everybody.
Jesus.
Darla felt the same way. It made her sick. You squirming inside her.
Oh, so, no. He does know what to push.
My fault. Holtz was a good man. All he ever wanted was for you to get the punishment you
twisted did. Man.
Doesn't it freak you out that she used to change your diapers? I mean, when you think about it. The first woman you boned.
That's the main issue I have with it.
The closest thing you've ever had to a mother. Doing your mom and trying to kill your dad.
Should change his name to Oedipus.
There should be a play. You think I care what you said? Some animal in a cage? Angel's my dad. I'm gonna cry. That's what he told me.
It would be fun to play Angelus, wouldn't it?
Angel's just something that you're forced to wear. You're my real father.
All right, if you say so.
I'm right here. All you have to do is...
I mean, with that logic, you could say Liam's your real father as well.
Go upstairs.
Yeah, go to your room, young man.
No.
Please.
Yeah.
And take your baggy shirt and go.
What's a better ride than a Mustang?
Well, let's not get into that.
Me.
Oh, we're getting into that.
Tell us about the beast, and you can do whatever you want.
Oh, man. If the world's gonna end because of the beast, surely he'd want to help, because otherwise he'll just die as soon as he's back.
It would be better if I knew.
It's better if you don't.
She needs to go down there and get all glowy and white on him like she did last season with Connor.
Seriously lacking in military.
It's funny to see Angelus in flashbacks and the present day stuff as well.
Body. The beast was next on their list. He couldn't touch them. Some kind of mojo. But a vampire could. So he wanted you to kill them. And I declined. He didn't ask twice.
It's a hell of a cut.
More diplomatic. The beast was banished. How? Don't know. I was busy with the passing out.
Good.
Swarf demon, spell mantra, shrill gong technique.
So why does he not remember it as Angel?
So where do we find these banishing babes, and how fast can they get to L.A.?
About 25 minutes, depending on traffic. They're in
Pacoima. Nice. See, this is why they shouldn't have retired the other pages.
It's open. Hello?
Always a good sign. Are they all dead? Yeah. Ah. Oh dear. Quite literally a dead end. Now, that's just emotional manipulation, TV show.
Connor.
Oh my. Is he allergic to calendars?
Vampires turn into dust like they were never anything at all. The humans. It's different.
See what happened when Joyce saw some dead kids. Taking out the trash. Oh. Oh. Nice.
It's time to bring back Angel.
You don't sound so sad about it.
The deal was, you give us information, we save the world, you get me. Well, world not saved.
You're not thinking I'm just gonna
let. Oh no, I have a bad feeling about that. Oh, didn't even flinch.
Not even close. What? Soul.
Oh, it's gone, isn't it?
It's gone.
Did it get hungry or something? What? Heck. Okay, another great episode. I like this one a hell of a lot. It was just cool to see Angela's back and being a bit of a nuisance, I think it's safe to say. But I can just imagine how fun it is to play Angela's, especially when you're so used to playing Angel as well. It must be great to get to do that switch, even when you have like flashback episodes and stuff. So to spend like the entire episode as Angelus as well, it's probably a lot of fun, because I mean, we didn't see Angel in this episode really, which is funny considering the name of the show, which is cool. I quite like that. It's interesting, and hopefully this will continue on for a bit longer. I don't know. I mean, Angelus will leave eventually. They'll get Angel back somehow. I don't know when. I feel like it's a bit too long to say this will be the rest of the season, because I feel like that might be a bit too long to not have Angel around for. But I'm not quite sure. I think it'll be another 3 episodes yet for sure, but we'll see. Obviously, it depends on how the arc's going to play out and how much they need Angelus for, but to see him play his mind games and kind of really get at everyone's insecurities is really cool. Drop a few bombshells as well. I love that he kind of, very knowingly, I would say, revealed that Connor and Cordelia had slept together to Fred and Gunn, because obviously they were unaware of that. So that was a really crazy moment. And that, I'm not sure if it was Angelus' true intention, but that kind of bled again into even Connor's insecurity when he thought, oh, they're all staring at me because they still think I'm connected to the Beast. You know, they think it's me who's the problem. And he's obviously, he's shown a lot of insecurity about that. So even when Angelus is trying to twist everyone else's buttons and kind of prey on their insecurities, they're influencing everyone else's insecurities as well, because that's affecting Connor kind of indirectly. Which is really interesting to just see how an evil mind works in that sense. And even when it seems Cordelia kind of had the upper hand on him at the end there with that conversation, standing up to him, not even flinching when he like reached for her, that was so badass. Even then, Angel's soul's gone. Don't know how that happened. Don't know who took it, why it's vanished. You know, was it the shaman guy for some reason? Connor could have taken, I mean, anyone could have taken it, really. Anyone could have slid in and taken it at any point. So no theories as to exactly what that's going to be about and where it's gone, who's taken it, etc. But it does mean Angelus is obviously going to be around for a little bit longer, which I'm happy with, because I've really enjoyed seeing him kind of get people like this. You know, we've obviously had a lot of the group turning on each other a lot, you know, last season, Wesley taking Connor and everything, there's a lot of that. Things still work perfectly right even now. Even though I thought they were last episode, but nope. But now, you know, even more so, they're turning on each other for various different reasons, not just because of, like, the big fight that's going on and potential apocalypse, everything with the Beast, like, even personal stuff as well. Like, Wesley's feelings for Fred, that kind of got played up on a lot, and Angel's kind of dropping the seeds there. Because I suppose he still has a lot of sense of Angel and Angel's knowledge of all those people. So he knew their insecurities, and he knew... if he brought that up, you know, that's going to be enough to kind of set Gunn off. That's going to be enough to set Wesley on that train of thought, thinking about Fred and his feelings for her all over again. And I suppose that kind of sped that impulsive action on Wesley's part when he kissed her. And it seems she kissed back a bit, which is a bit of a thing. I mean, it's a tricky one, that one. I mean, Wesley's entirely in the wrong to make a move. Not about that life. But I do think Wesley and Fred suit each other. I would be okay with them exploring that relationship, but just wait until Gunn and Fred kind of called it quits. If they called it quits, it's just such a common TV thing to do, isn't it? I just don't like love triangles particularly. I think that's just a personal taste thing, really, so I'm never going to be big on that. Because, you know, with that, in Waiting in the Wings and stuff, I was definitely more rooting for Wesley and Fred to happen, I would say. But they went down the Fred and Gunn route, and they've proven to be a really nice couple as well. So there wasn't really a bad option out of that. And, you know, it then led Wesley to have an interesting relationship with Lila and stuff like that, which was cool to see. But such an inconvenient moment to circle back to this whole thing with Angelus around. And it was just the fact that Wesley was the one making this big speech, you know, don't let Angelus get to you, don't let him do this, don't let him do that. And he seems to maintain his composure when he was one-on-one with Angelus. And then just suddenly it felt a bit like impulsive. I don't know if it was just Angelus bringing up that again that caused Wesley to be like, I just need to kiss her. It's a mood, buddy. I get it. But she's with Gunn. I have some respect for that. So that was annoying. I wasn't particularly pleased about that decision on Wesley's behalf. But also, you know, it kind of exploded into this big argument, and Wesley and Gunn were kind of at each other's throats again. It's not the right time to think, people think. That's very frustrating that they spent like 20 minutes going over what Angelus was trying to do, and the whole episode was them being like, you know, he's taking some truths and twisting them into lies. You know, this is what he wants. We're playing into his hands. They were saying that to themselves again and again and again, and they still fell for it at every opportune moment, really. You know, even delivering the blood to Angelus, he made a move on Fred then and grabbed her, and I was like, come on, people. So yeah, it's messy, and I don't know if that speaks more to the brilliance of Angelus and the genius of Angelus, or just the incompetence of the group for the sake of the plot. I don't know which one it is. I feel like it's probably maybe a mix, because you know, we're only halfway through the season. Things still need to go wrong for the team. They can't have a win and even getting the information they wanted out of Angelus didn't really go anywhere, because all the witchy people, things who banished the Beast before, are now dead. Well, at least that bloodline's all dead. And it was sad to see that kind of kid die and everything. And I did enjoy that really kind of had an impact on Connor. I liked that. That was a very humanising moment for, you know, a boy who was raised in the Hell Dimension. And was the child of two, like, undead vampires. It's good to kind of humanise him like that, and, you know, you can kind of understand where he's coming from in that kind of situation. So I did like how they approached that, but then on the other hand, he's like, oh good, everyone knows about me and Cordelia now, maybe you don't want to be with me, but don't tell him what I need to do, like, oh, get a grip, buddy. I feel like the real reason that rubs me the wrong way is that he spent like, what, 15, 16 years being raised by Holtz? Holtz would not have that, you know, he would not tolerate that attitude. So the fact that that was still ingrained, like that wasn't ingrained out of him, I think it's kind of surprising to me. And like, what? How did Holtz raise you then? It seemed like he was a bit brutal about it. And I don't know. I feel like Holtz wouldn't let him get away with that. And maybe that's why Connor's just over-exaggerating it now, because he thinks he can get away with it. But I just feel like he should know not to do that because of Holtz and his methods and stuff. But I guess we didn't really see much of Holtz actually raising Connor. So, I don't know. It's a difficult situation in regards to that, I suppose. But I did like more of the humanising moments with Connor in this one, even if he still has a few, like, stand my head against the wall moments as well. And yeah, getting some flashbacks to the Beast and Angelus' meeting, seeing exactly what was going on there, and the fact that the Beast wanted Angelus to kill all the people that could banish him, but he ended up getting banished anyway. They still didn't explain why Angel didn't remember that fact, so I guess there's still more to explain there. It also felt like they were trying to wrap that up. But now, you know, Angelus has served his purpose in this story arc, but Angel's soul's gone, so he's still going to be sticking around. What happens next with that? That I'm very intrigued by, and I quite like that a lot. She feel like, okay, you know, they didn't get anything out of Angelus, but, well, they got everything they needed out of Angelus, but ultimately led to a dead end, quite literally. I guess that's where they were going with that arc. It's just a cool excuse to see Angelus again, but no, my friends, there's going to be more to it, which I quite like. It kind of breaks up the structure of where you think the story may be going, which I appreciate. That is a kind of twist I do appreciate, for sure, as opposed to like the Connor and Cordelia thing, which is a twist I did not appreciate, and that's a bad twist. But still, everyone is out in the open and knows about it now, so maybe they can properly address it and move forward. But, you know, we got them addressing that and moving forward in the last episode. It turned out to be false. And again, it's just going to lose the impact, I think, if we do ever properly address that. But there's still so much going on. Things are so complicated. And they're adding this other love triangle with the whole Wesley friend gun thing, bringing that back up. It's just a bit, ooh, there's a lot happening. So I feel like those character details may not be getting addressed anytime soon, because there's a lot of plot happening right now, which is fair enough if they don't want to address it properly and, you know, sit down and have everyone talk things out, you know, go on Dr. Phil or something. I don't know. That's the way they want to go about it, the writers and the showrunners and stuff. Fine, I can't influence how the story's going to change, can I? This is 20 years old. But yeah, it's basically very messy, is what I'm trying to say. But Cordelia was great in this one. I liked her trying to make this deal with Angelus, kind of, yeah, putting herself out there, offering herself up to Angelus, which is very brave of her, and kind of, yeah, potentially willing to sacrifice herself to get this information, and then kind of going back on that deal she made because it didn't really work out that way and it ended up being a dead end and stuff. I like that she was kind of holding her own against him. It was good to see someone not crumble against him, kind of stand up for him, and stand up for Angel as well, which was nice. But you can just imagine the look on Angelus' face when he finds out that they don't have the soul anymore. I imagine he's going to be in for a hell of a time and sing that creepy Go Down to the Woods Today song yet again. Is it like Teddy Bear's Picnic or something? Oh, and that kid had a teddy bear, the dead kid. I imagine that's a purposeful connection. Teddy Bear's Picnic and then boy, the teddy bear being slaughtered. Not a nice connection, granted. It's very disturbing and horrible and sad, but I quite like that. And just seeing like little Angelus quirks, he's like, oh, I missed out on all the fun when he heard all those people were like being slaughtered. It's just, he's a fun character to watch, even if he's a nasty bastard. You kind of like him stirring the pot in that way, and, you know, we'll just see where it all goes. You know, the point is, you know, it was the wrong time and place for Wesley and Gunn to have that spat. You know, that's the whole point, that you're supposed to be frustrated by it because there are bigger things going on, but it's just showing how Angelus kind of is. And the fact that most of them haven't dealt with Angelus before does kind of make me a bit more okay with it. Because Cordelia is the one who definitely has the most experience with Angelus, and she was the one who kind of was best with him and dealt with him the best in this episode. So it does make sense, but you also do feel like the team should know better, but don't, it would seem. And is that for the sake of plot? It's probably a bit of both that, and, you know, you can kind of understand the characters' heads are being messed around by Angelus. Angelus is very good at being a dick. But yeah, we'll see where they take all of this and where the soul's gone, who's taken it, what's gone on there. Who knows? But I'm excited to find out. And yeah, I mean, it's the halfway point of the season, so it makes sense that things are getting even worse than ever. And there's still a lot of fighting in between, you know, within the team, and things are getting complicated. And the Wesley and Fred thing was the biggest shock for me, them kissing. So there's going to be more explored there, I suppose. I mean, have shown Fred and Gunn go through a bit of issues lately after everything. Was it episode 4 or 5, something like that, I think. Can't quite remember now. But when things kind of start to go a bit wrong, when Gunn killed the professor guy, there have been cracks in that relationship, so just Angelus was kind of playing on that as well. But it's a hot, hot mess, but I am excited to see where they take a lot of these stories, and it is cool to have Angelus back and definitely going to be sticking around for at least a little bit longer, to see Angel going missing his soul. Yeah, lots of good stuff with there. I really like them humanising Connor, and his reaction to seeing the dead humans was actually very relatable and real, and makes you remember that this kid is still basically a kid and very young, doesn't have a lot of experience with dead humans as opposed to dead demons and stuff. I know vampires are kind of dead humans, but still. Innocent dead humans, I should say. So that was really nice. Cordelia was pretty badass in this one. Preying on like the insecurities of Wesley and his feelings for Fred. Bringing up his father, which we know he kind of has not the best relationship with his dad. And he's very insecure about himself and his failings as like Faith's Watcher. I like that we got a mention of Faith and Wesley's past as a Watcher as well. That's really cool. His fear of being, you know, a failure, and Jess was prying on that. Gunn's insecurity about, you know, Wesley and Fred and that potentially being a thing, and then actually seeing that play out, almost walking in on that. You know, he's kind of snapped about that in the past when it hadn't even happened, but now it has. So, yeah, I kind of feel for the guy there, because that was a bad move on Wesley's part. That was... I don't think that's in the bro code, Wesley. I know you're not really bros anymore, but still. It's no excuse. That was not the finest moment. But we also had Angelus in this episode, so it's not like Wesley, you know, did like the worst action ever in this one. But again, cycling back to him taking Connor and stuff, there's a lot of nice references to lots of mistakes that the characters have made, and it makes sense that with all that coming up, bubbling to the surface, old tensions, rising, and not everyone's going to have their head in the game. Certainly not Angel's, because his soul's gone missing. So I liked that a lot, and Angelus is a lot of fun to watch. So, really great episode. I love this one a lot. Can't wait to see where I'm going to take things from here. And yeah, we're halfway through the season, which is fun. So I have a season and a half left of Angel. But I'm actually enjoying the season quite a bit so far. The Connor and Cordelia thing is no, thank you. But everything else I've actually quite enjoyed about this season. So where they go with it, not quite sure. But I'm excited for it nonetheless, especially if we get more Angelus stuff, which I was always hoping for from watching Angel the show. So excited for that. I think that's the end of this current Buffyverse cycle. And next one, I believe, is two Angels and a Buffy, I think. But it's definitely Angel next. So we'll be revisiting this very soon. But until next reaction, thanks for watching.